Hey guys, and welcome back to the Danish Woodsman. Today we're gonna do another theoretical video, so to speak, like when I told you guys how to purchase a Bark River knife, because today we're gonna talk about a subject which should seem kind of obvious, but for some reason is quite frequently asked about in the Bark River forums, and I thought that you guys might be interested to know as well. So today we are gonna talk about what steels Bark River used to produce their knife, and what their features are. So if you want to know more about the steels and their features, stick around. So guys, what we are looking at here is the knife steels that Bark River are producing, and this is a knife steel sheath, so to speak, with an overview of all the steels and their features. So if you look at it, you can see in the horizontal line is the name of the different steels, and the vertical line is a measure schedule for their performances in the two categories, the blue, which is toughness, and the red, which is wear resistant. So the higher on the vertical scale they go, the better they are in that category. So let's jump right into it, and as you can see, the red arrows on the different steel names represent the steels that Bark River are currently using in their production. So what we're going to do is we're going to work our way from the left towards the right. And as you can see, the first steel we see on the left side is the A2 steel. But I would actually like to start one step more to the left at D2, even though there is an error, because back in the day, Bark River actually used to produce their knives in D2 steel. But they have, or CPM D2, I actually believe. I'm actually not quite sure, but they used to produce the knife, some of their knives in D2 steel too. But have in the newer time decided to move away from that steel because the heat treat was really difficult to get right and would be. And if it wasn't completely right, the knife would suffer severely from chipping and not being tough enough. But that's just a quick side note. Let's talk about the first steel on the schedule, which is A2. And as you can see down in the bottom of the steel sheath, the blue bar represents toughness and the red bar represents wear resistant. So as you can see, A2 definitely excels in toughness, but still has a decent amount of wear resistant, which is better than the D2 steel. The next steel that Bark River are using on this schedule is the CPM 154 CM, which I actually believe is not correct. I would actually say that they have, since this was made, moved again one step more to the right and used CPM S35VN. And either way, these two steels, as you can see, is characterized in different from A2 by having a lot more wear resistance and being it's called stainless. So one of the prime features of this steel, of these two steels, the CPM 154CM and the CPM S35VN, is that they are stainless and super duper wear resistant while still being super tough. The next steel on the sheath is the LMAX steel, which is a really, really popular steel, usually for small or medium sized models. And I believe this is also a stainless steel. As you can see, this is a really, really tough steel, but it's also super wear resistant. It's really, really wear resistant. So if you have a knife, or if you want to looking to buy a knife that you don't have to sharpen all the time and doesn't have to take that much care of, CPM S35VN or LMAX is a superb steel. As I said, LMAX is maybe the ideal steel, are the best steel of all time to put on an EDC blade, because you don't have to worry about it. You can put it in your pocket every day, use it every day, and still be sure still be confident it will stay sharp and not rust away if you're using it every day. So if we move a couple of steps to the right. Once again, we'll meet the CPM 3V steel at the red, at the next red arrow. And this is a steel that you should be familiar with, because this has become the standard steel for Bark River. It used to be the A2 steel all that we first talked about all at the left side. It used to be Bark River standard steel. I would say that 3PM 3V has become the standard steel, as you can see, it is massively improved and massive improved over the A2 steel. You can see just how insanely tough, how high this stuff reaches at the toughness scale. It is insanely tough, and I can really, really speak up. And in my experience, that's definitely true. I have owned the GX5 for quite a while now, in almost 2 years in CPM 3V, and I have been beating on that thing mercilessly, and it hasn't failed me yet. So as I said, CPM 3V, it has become Bark River's standard steel, and is characterized by its insane toughness, while still being super duper wear resistant. As you can see, it is not quite as wear resistant as LMAX or CPM S35V, but it's not a long way off. So we have to take care of it and sharpen it. But it's super super tough. And just because it is that tough, it doesn't mean it isn't wear resistant. It will still stay sharp for a super long time. It just isn't as wear resistant as the LMAX steel. And another steel that has become quite popular, for some people at least, is the next one we're going to take a look at, which is the CPM CV, which stands for CPM Crewwear. Which is also a super high-end steel, and you guys might want to correct me in the comments, but I believe that this one is stainless too. And you can see this is really, really tough too. The blue bar is almost as high as the 3V steel, but the perk of this crewwear steel is you can see how much higher the wear resistance is in contrast to the CPM 3V. You can see the red bar on crewwear goes all the way to a 3, I believe, on the scale, on the vertical scale, while the 3V only goes to a 2. So it's super duper tough and wear resistant. So it really, in this crewwear steel, you really get the best of both worlds, and that's why it has become a really popular steel, but I believe also a more expensive steel than CPM 3V. And that's why you will not see CPM crewwear on as many models as 3V, just because the price of the knife would be significantly higher if crewwear were to be used on it. And the last steel that Bark River is currently using, and we can see in this sheath, is the CPM 1V steel, which they only have used on one waddle so far, which is the Bravo Machete. And as you can see, this is obviously the toughest steel out there. It is ridiculous. You can see the toughness is right up there, completely out of the teeth, a full-on 9. So by a mile, if you thought 3V or crewwear is tough, this is like out of this world. It is insanely tough, but at the price of not being as wear resistant, and thereby not said it isn't wear resistant, it just isn't so rare wear resistant as some of the other steels. So you'll have to take care of it and sharpen it, but it is virtually unbreakable, and that's why they chose to use it on the machete, because you're obviously going to do a lot of chopping and branch clearing, and the machete is quite, I would say, to the shorter and sturdier side, so a lot of people would be doing wood chopping with it, and therefore it made really good sense to test out the 1V steel on the machete, and it worked really, really well. So I will not be surprised to see more models with the 1V steel in the future. But yeah, as I said, this has been a quick overview of the steels that Bark River are currently using. As I said, let's just quickly do a sum up. They used to have A2 as the standard steel. They still do A2 on some models on the in what is it called, the autumn. They are probably gonna do a run of Bravo 1 Serenade 2 just for the nostalgia reason. But the new standard still has become CPM3V, which is super tough and super resistant. It's kind of the best of both worlds. They offer stainless models in CPM S35VN and CPM 154CM and LMAX, and maybe Crewware is also stainless. And as I said, Crewware is just a tiny step up over CPM3V with a better wear resistance. And 1V they have only used for one model so far, the Machete, because of its insane toughness. So I hope this video will help you if you're sitting there and looking at the websites and trying to figure out the difference between the steels. Maybe my ramble here has helped you, and maybe you only needed to look at the knife sheath. But anyway, this has been the Danish Woodsman, and if this video has been helpful, maybe drop me a like. And if you want to stay up to date with what Bark River is doing, be sure to subscribe, and I will in the near future do a overview of the Bark River Cap Art, so definitely stay tuned to that. And now I'll go outside, and I hope to see you out there. Bye.